Finn, tuba mouthpiece. My name is Dan. I want to do a review of this tuba mouthpiece. I've been looking for a while now to upgrade from what came standard on my E-flat bass, or the E-flat bass I am using. It is not mine, but played for a long time with a Bach 24AW, big bowl of a mouthpiece. And in fact, it was a 24AW Megatone, which had, it looked like a big old bullet. The size was okay, but it really kept me from producing a I don't want to say a clear, totally clear sound, but the sound, it felt very much like I had a piece of rag stacked in my horn and I was trying to play through it. Very stuffy. Anyhow, this also does have that heavy weight mass, but it's not as, it's, I think it's just the right amount to keep the sound focused across the range. Well centered, the pitch is very well centered, and again, in those very loud moments where you want to just give it all, the sound will remain focused. It's not going to splat everywhere in the sound spectrum. It does still have, it has a core. It's not fuzzy. It's not at the end of the spectrum where it's like really, really warm and fuzzy, but it does keep it together nicely. I really enjoyed this. I really want to encourage you to give it a try and see what you think. Mine is a 2B, which is the model that's a 33 millimeter rim and a deep bowl shaped cup. The backboard is is just the right size for this type of mouthpiece. I'm really enjoying this and I look forward to playing it some more. What can I say? It's a Mike puts out a beautiful, beautiful work here. And for sure, I think that if you want to get this in gold, he does make a variant where just the rim is gold or the whole thing is gold. It's really, really quite stunning to look at. But more importantly, the sound. That's what you're going for. The low range greatly improves. It's just something about the combination of the extra mass and the combination, the right amount of opening in the back bore that it hits him right away. It's very, very nice for the low end, particularly if you want to go big. Again, what can I say? I really enjoy this, guys. I'm going to keep doing some more of these. Here comes the audio sound in a little bit. It's just a tidbit. I apologize again for the sound quality of the recording. That we're talking about gain and compression rates and gains and so on, but it's something. I've not found too many helpful reviews online, and I hope this kind of gives you a live playing review, a little bit, gives you some information on this. Really, really enjoy this. Check it out. Mm-hmm.